So today we're going to hear a pretty well-known Bible story. It's the story of Noah's Ark. Now when I was a kid, I used to kind of get hung up and focused on the cute animals or the really big boat. But as we're going to see, there are more important things going on in that story. Things that are still important for you and me today. Now, remember last week. Last week we talked about the very first sin. Well, at this point of the story, things didn't get better. Things had actually gone from bad to worse. Sin didn't stop and die out, it actually kind of spiraled out of control. The Lord saw how bad the sins of everyone on earth had become. They only thought about evil things. The Lord was very sad that he had made human beings on the earth. His heart was filled with pain. So the Lord said, "I created human beings, but I will wipe them out. I will also destroy the animals, the birds in the sky, and the creatures that move along the ground. I'm very sad that I have made human beings." Now that's serious. Like, really serious. That's how serious God takes sin. It's a problem. Sin is a problem. It brought all these terrible things into God's good creation. Stuff like violence, pain, sadness, greed, the list goes on and on. Sin was a problem and something needed to happen. People had turned their backs on God. People had turned their backs on the one that had brought them into existence. And all of that though, God still loved people. And he didn't want that to be the end of the story. Here's the short version of what happened. There was a man named Noah, and Noah was the only one who followed God at that time. So God had Noah build a giant boat, so that when the flood came, him and his family would be safe. He also made sure that it would be big enough so that animals could be sheltered in the ark too. Then God set the flood and everything was destroyed, but the people and the animals that were in the ark were safe. Noah would send birds out to see if the water had started to go down yet or not. And when a dove came back with an olive branch, Noah knew the flood was going away. Once Noah and his family were safely back on dry ground, the first thing they did was build an altar, made an offering to God, and worshiped him. Now that's not actually the end of the story though, because after everything, God came to Noah and told him some really important things. And they're so important that I want you guys to hear them word for word. Let's listen. Then God spoke to Noah and to his sons who were with him. He said, "I am now making my covenant with you and with all your children who will be born after you. I am making it also with every living creature that was with you in the ark. I am making my covenant with the birds, the livestock, and all the wild animals. I am making it with all the creatures that came out of the ark with you. In fact, I am making it with every living thing on earth. Here is my covenant that I am making with you. The waters of a flood will never again destroy all life. A flood will never again destroy the earth." God continued, "My covenant is between me and you and every living creature with you. It is a covenant for all time to come. Here is the sign of the covenant I am making. I have put my rainbow in the clouds. It will be the sign of the covenant between me and the earth. Sometimes when I bring clouds over the earth, a rainbow will appear in them. Then I will remember my covenant between me and you and every kind of living creature. The waters will never again become a flood to destroy all life. When the rainbow appears in the clouds, I will see it. I will remember that my covenant will last forever. It is a covenant between me and every kind of living creature on earth." So God said to Noah, "The rainbow is the sign of my covenant. I have made my covenant between me and all life on earth." So God told Noah that he was making a covenant with him. Now, covenant is a really important word, and it comes up a lot in the Bible, especially when we're talking about God and his people. So what is a covenant? Well, a covenant is kind of like a contract, you know, where two people agree that they're going to do different things. But it's more important than that. A covenant's also kind of like a promise, and that's really important too, because especially with God, when God makes promises, he keeps them. But again, it's a little bit more than that. I think the best example to kind of help us see this is a marriage. Because you see, in a marriage, two people promise that they're going to love and support each other till death do they part. And when they make those promises, they do it publicly. But it's not just some cold contract, some cold agreement, because both of those people really truly care deeply about each other. So Yeah, when you hear the word covenant, you can think covenant means promise. But also remember, it's bigger and deeper than that. So what did God promise in this covenant? Well, he promised that he would never flood the whole earth again. God would never destroy the whole earth with rain. And he meant it so much that he gave us a sign. Do you guys remember what the sign of the promise was? That's right, it was a rainbow. And that's a really good reminder, because a lot of times when it rains, we can see rainbows in the clouds. And it can remind us, just like it reminds God, that he's never again going to destroy the whole earth with rain again. But there is more. So to understand this, we need to start with the word rainbow. Now, rainbow is one word that's really actually two words smashed together. So the first part's obvious, rain. That's really clear, right? But the second word, bow, well, bow can have multiple meanings. So first it's bow, not bow. It's also not the kind of bow that you put in your hair. What kind of bow does a rainbow look like? That's right, the kind of bow that like Robin Hood uses, or Legolas, or Katniss. So why is that important? Well, okay, think about a bow. Now think about rainbows. And when you see a rainbow, what direction is the rainbow pointed? What direction is it aimed? Well, rainbows are pointed, they're aimed up at heaven. God was taking it and pointing it up at himself to give us a hint, and now it's a reminder. A hint that sin is serious, but God was going to take care of it a different way. You see, God was going to take the hurt, the pain, the punishment on himself. He was going to die so that we wouldn't have to. It's what happened with Jesus on the cross. So in the midst of a sad story that all too often we just kind of gloss over and go right through, we see again that it's a love story. The whole Bible is. There's another thing that we need to see, and that's everything in the Bible points to Jesus. He said so as much himself. After Jesus rose again from the dead, he was walking on the road and saw two disciples, and then he explained to them what was said in all the scriptures concerning himself. So again, when we read the Bible, we need to remember that the Bible is much more about God than it is about us. And also, we need to remember that everything in the Bible points us to Jesus, just like God's bow. Today we learned that sin is serious. It was a problem that God was going to have to take care of. We also learned that after the flood, sin was still a problem. And God promised Noah, he made a covenant with Noah and all the people that came after, that he was never going to flood the whole earth again. God gave us a sign, something to remember that promise with his rainbow. But the rainbow also reminds us that Jesus was going to come, and Jesus was going to die for us. Jesus was going to die to take care of sin once and for all, so that we wouldn't have to. Let's talk to him now. Dear Jesus, thank you for coming and doing what we couldn't. Thank you for taking care of sin, for dying, and for rising again. We're sorry for all the times that we've gone our own way and not yours. Help us to live in love more like you, and help us to remember your promises. We pray this and the prayer that you taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Streams of grace flow deep and wide.
Thank you so much for joining us for our online family worship. If you'd like to hear more about the story of Noah's Ark and how it has to do with God's love for us, please check out Pastor's message here on our channel. Have a great week, everybody.